Integrating VoiceThread with your course makes it very easy for students to access their coursework. All they have to do is sign into their accounts and click on a VoiceThread link that you have already created for them. This tutorial will go over how to create and set up that link. Your first step is to add a VoiceThread link to your course. Please refer to the instructions for your specific learning management system in order to do this. After you've added a VoiceThread link to your course, just click on it to see the setup options. This is where you'll decide what your students see when they click on the link. The option you choose here will be permanent for this one link. Let's go over each option individually. When you select the course view, that takes you to a collection of all the VoiceThreads that have been shared with your course. You and your students can click on any thumbnail to open that VoiceThread and participate. You can also click Add Your Own to create a new VoiceThread, or select from those you've already created to share with the rest of the course. You can search through all the VoiceThreads already shared, or you can click on the menu icon to sort by various criteria. If you need to go to your VT homepage, just click on Go to VT Home, and at the end of a semester or academic session, you can click on Disable Course to turn off the course for your students. When you select the VT Home option, this takes students to their own home pages, where they can see all of the VoiceThreads that have been shared with them or that they have created. In addition, they can click on the sidebar icon to see all of their courses in VoiceThread, and they can click on any one course to see the collection of VoiceThreads shared just with that course. When you select the individual VT option, that allows you to point students to a specific VoiceThread. This is great for using a VoiceThread that you've already created as a conversation space. You'll see a list of all your VoiceThreads on the left, and just click on one and click Share with Class in order to use it. But if you have not yet created the VoiceThread you'd like to use, click Create New VoiceThread at the top. Here, you can upload the media that you would like to use, give your VoiceThread a title, and save. Once your media has uploaded, you can click Comment at the top of the page to record some comments. Just close out of this when you're done, click on Share with Class, and you're done setting up your link. Students will be taken directly to this VoiceThread when they click on the link in your course. The Assignment Builder is the portion of VoiceThread that will integrate with your learning management system's gradebook. There are several steps to setting this up, so let's take a look at them one by one. There are three types of VoiceThread assignment: a Create assignment, a Comment assignment, and a Watch assignment. Let's set up a Comment assignment. Here you'll see all the VoiceThreads you've ever created, and you just need to select the one you want to require students to comment on. Give the assignment a description, and set the number of comments you want to require of your students. Over on the right side, you can opt to share the VoiceThread with your class. It will be shared by default, and you can turn on comment moderation. This means that students cannot see one another's answers or comments, so it's a great option for assessment. When you're ready, just click Create Assignment, and you're done. If you have not yet created the VoiceThread you'd like to use for this assignment, click on Create New VoiceThread at the top. Here you can upload the media that you would like to use, give your VoiceThread a title, and save. Click Comment at the top to record some comments and give students instruction. Then click on the X in the top right corner when you're done, and click Create Assignment. Here again, you can give your assignment a description, require a certain number of comments of your students, change your settings, and click Create Assignment. When you're ready to grade the assignment, just go back to your course and click on the same link again. This time, you'll be taken to the VoiceThread grader for this assignment. Here, you'll see a summary of your assignment, including its title, below that, a description, and below that, a link to the VoiceThread you used if this is a Create or a Watch assignment. You'll also see that you need to grade on a percentage scale, so a grade of 0 to 100. On the right, you see your class roster, and it's subdivided between those students who have submitted and those who have not. For the students who have not submitted, just hover your mouse over their name and click on the Remind button to send them a reminder email to complete the assignment. For the students who have submitted, simply click on the student's name and their work will load on the left. Just click on any comment in order to jump directly to that one comment. And when you're ready, just enter a grade on a scale of 0 to 100 into the text box on the right. Hit enter on your keyboard, and that grade will immediately be saved into your course gradebook. And that's all you need to know about using VoiceThread in your courses. Now that you're an expert, go give it a try with your students and see how you can make your courses better with VoiceThread.